Techno Update. Subscribe now. Asus Zenfone R review. The Asus Zenfone R has what it takes for good phone VR thanks to its high-resolution OLED screen. It's 5.7 inches across, with a resolution of 1440 by 2560. The CPU is a high-end, but no longer top-end, quad-core Snapdragon 821. While there are versions of the Asus Zenfone R with a mammoth 8 GB of RAM and 128 GB of storage, the phone we're reviewing has 6 GB of RAM and 64 GB of storage. Design and display. Hardware-wise, you get a clicky finger scanner below the screen that acts as a normal home button if you don't use finger security, and light up soft keys to either side. This isn't the fastest fingerprint scanner around, a beat slower than something like the Honor 9, but only those who have spent altogether too much time with phones will notice. The NanoSIM lives in the usual tray that pops out of the Asus Zenfone R's side, and there's space for a microSD card if the 64/128 GB of storage isn't enough for you. The phone screen is a 5.7-inch 1440 by 2560 OLED panel. It's big, sharp and punchy, with an excellent 515 pixel density. Battery life. That's only a little smaller than the 3,500 mAh battery of the Samsung Galaxy S8 Plus, but the Asus Zenfone R's stamina isn't great. It's not bad either though. It's fine, and will get you through a day's use as long as you don't spend too much time listening to podcasts, or Spotify, or do a lot of gaming. 90 minutes of video playback with the brightness set to maximum takes 20% off the battery. The Samsung Galaxy S8 Plus lost just 11% in the same test, the LG G6 14%, despite using the same CPU. Camera. The Asus Zenfone R has a rear camera with seriously impressive sounding specs. It has a tri-camera setup on the back led by a 23MP main camera, a Sony IMX318. As it's a 4:3 shaped sensor, you'll actually take 16MP shots if you shoot widescreen. Top features of the camera include optical image stabilization for good low-light photo quality and a super resolution mode that merges several exposures to make a huge 92MP image.